Jaebong used to speak well, but this time, this evening, I'm afraid he spoke a little too long before the main speaker. 네, 고맙습니다. 반갑습니다. 양해해 주시면 영어로 말씀드리겠습니다. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. As we celebrate the 10th anniversary of the Asan Institute for Policy Studies, I would like to thank all those in this room, all those who have helped us along the way. Asan is the pen name of my father, the late Jeong Ju-young. Asan, it is also the name of the home village, Asan-ni, 강원도 통천군 송전면 아산리, on the foothills of Mount Geumgang, now in North Korea. My father grew up in a very poor farming family. He received 3 years of classical Confucian training at a traditional Confucian school called Sodang. His teacher was his grandfather. Then he attended a local elementary school run by the Japanese colonial government for 3 years. That was all the formal education that he received. This is the picture of my father in his 20s. As he toiled on the farm, his dream was to move to the city. His dream was fanned by what he read in Dongha Ilbo, the only newspaper available to him. The paper was delivered every day to the village elder. He was able to read the paper only after all the village elders had gone through the paper. He pored over each and every word of the story because it was the only source of information about the outside world. He said he was naive enough to think that the stories in the serialized novels in the paper were all true. At the age of 16, he made his way to Seoul on foot, begging for food on the trip. Before starting an auto repair shop, he worked as a stevedore in the docks of Incheon, as a construction site worker, and as a rice delivery boy. The rest, as they say, is a history. My father yearned for home. His favorite place in South Korea was Gangneung, the venue for the 2018 Winter Olympics. That was the closest he could get to his home village. He could no longer return to because of national division. That is why he wanted to help the people of North Korea. When the opportunity came for him to do so, he did. He started the Mount Geumgang tourist project as well as the Gaesong industrial complex. In 1998, 20 years ago, he took 1,001 heads of cow loaded on more than 100 Hyundai trucks across the DMZ, which dramatized the beginning of inter-Korean exchanges. It has been said that the North Koreans far more appreciated the trucks than the cows. However, he had no illusions about the reality of the division. When he visited his relatives in North Korea, he was able to stay the night. In the middle of the night, his aunt pulled him under the cover of a thick blanket and whispered into my father's ears, "Please, don't try to help. please go back as soon as possible. My father understood what she meant. Today, we stand at another critical juncture. I'm happy that the Asan Institute has become a gathering place for important ideas and leading experts in Korea and the region. I would like to thank the Asan Institute's board members and President Ham Jae-bong for their work in building the institute and for organizing this very important and very interesting conference. Let us all give them a big round of applause. Thank you very much. Both Jae-bong and I are Johns Hopkins alumni. Jae-bong was born in Boston when his father was attending Harvard Law School. Jae-bong's father worked as Korean ambassador to Washington, very unfortunately later passed away in Rangoon, the bombing by North Korea. His family moved back to Korea when Jae-bong was 1 year old, taking a train from Boston to San Francisco and then by a U.S. military cargo ship across the Pacific to Japan and then South Korea. That was the most economic way to get home at the time. The world has changed a lot since then. Korea has also gone through a great transformation. However, one thing never seems to change. Korea is a small player in a tough neighborhood. Our security environment is undergoing rapid change once again. South Korea is like a small boat tossed by the ocean. If we look at the sheer magnitude of the geopolitics of the vast Eurasian continent, the fact that a small country like South Korea, located at the eastern tip of the continent, survives as a free democracy is a miracle in progress. In order for us to sustain this miracle, I ask for your wisdom in these very turbulent times. Thank you very much.